Hey, what's up, Internet? I'm Duke of the Bump, and I'm going to be streaming LaserCat. This game is available on Xbox Live Indie Games and also the PC game downloading service Desera. It costs $2 on Desera. I'm not sure what it costs on XBLA. This is an exploration platform game. There might be some puzzly elements in there as well. I didn't really dive into it too much. I just long enough to check it out. What is up, straight line in the chat room? Let me type something into the chat room to sync up the chat. Lasers and cats. Now, unfortunately, the chat script, or the script that Exergia made that let me convert the chat room into subtitles for YouTube, the website where that's hosted no longer exists. So, Exergia, if you're watching this, let me know if you can hook me up with that script or host it anywhere else, because I really, really liked that I was able to do that for my YouTube videos. So, this game is played with the keyboard, and you can also use an Xbox 360 controller, as you can see in the instructions here. I'll just be using the keyboard. I was using Joy-to-Key, so I could use my PS2 controller, but I think my PS2 controller is it's almost out of commission. The D-pad, I'm having a lot of issues with it being unresponsive and stiff, and I think it's about time to retire it. But this game, it's pretty easy from what I've played so far. Not a whole lot of really tricky platforming or anything. Just kind of a nice relaxing romp, as the music would indicate. Let's see. There are achievements. I did play a little bit just to get a feel for the game, but I hardly did anything. Oh, this is cool. I cleared my save from earlier because I didn't want to start from the middle. And on the clear save data screen, you have to press QWOP at the same time to clear your game, which I thought was kind of funny, kind of a nod to Quap in the game. All right, so let's dive in here. Does everything look and sound okay in the chat room? I'm still a little paranoid because my Hotline Miami stream, the audio quality on it was subpar, and I'm not really sure why, but I tweaked my settings and hopefully it sounds okay now. Can you guys actually hear me? Oh, there's probably a delay. Sound good? Hello, Private Steve. Alright, well, let's get started. The story. LaserCat and Owl lived in this little house. Kind of reminds me of The Little Prince. Just a little asteroid. Sounds good? Okay. Space onions and astro carrots. Sounds pretty good, actually. I could go for some of that soup. The disco dungeon? I really hope that's a location in this game. Wizard spelled with 2 Z's, as in Rincewind the Wizard. Okay, so this magic space frog, whose name is Wizard, kidnapped my owl and is holding it ransom for 1 million British pounds sterling. And that's it. That's the story. So this is LaserCat. You can move, you can jump, and on certain platforms you can fall through it, like this platform here, if you press control. We'll get back to that point later, presumably. And there are signs scattered around with instructions. And when you're at these checkpoints, you can warp by pressing Q, and this is all of the map that we've uncovered so far. You might notice some similarities to VVVVVV, and I have to admit it is a little derivative of that game. But, you know, the style of VVVVVV was derivative of old Commodore 64 and other, you know, early PC games. So It's not really... You can't complain about this game being derivative unless you also complain about VVVVVV being derivative. I guess the lesson here is it's okay to be derivative as long as it's of something that you haven't seen in a while. But I still like it, and I like VVVVVV too. So, derivativeness never really bothered me that much. Okay, but anyway, let's head back. Not a whole lot of animation to LaserCat there. And also, there's no way to fire lasers, as far as I can see. That might come into play later. Entrance, 5 British pounds sterling. Well, I don't have that either. I have no British pounds sterling, as far as I can tell. And this explains the gusts, which are just, like, tubes that transport you from one location to the next. You can't control yourself while you're in the gusts. Use checkpoints to store keys and save your progress. So you can see down at the bottom there are 30 keys left, and I have 0 of them. So in order to save our friend, we're going to have to locate him, first of all. And second of all, we're going to have to get all 30 keys that we need to save him, presumably. And it doesn't tell you where any of that on the map is, just where you've been. So you have a nice big world to explore here. Like I said, there's not really much action to this game, per se. It's not a difficult game, at least from what I've played. And I don't know if there are actual puzzles or not. That remains to be seen. And when you die, all that happens is that you restart at the most recent checkpoint. and this is the room that we fell down into earlier. So I will not bother with that. And the streams also serve as like one-way passages to keep you out of certain areas. So the only way to get into that room is from the bottom. So let's drop down here, hit this checkpoint. I've been thinking about streaming my attempts at playing Super Meat Boy because I went back to that game recently. I was watching the Awesome Games Done Quick stream of Super Meat Boy, and it really made me want to play that game again. But I've been having some issues with the controls. Like, I would never... Oh, wait, there's a ghost cat here that we can talk to. They ate me, and now they're going to eat you. These are scattered around all over the world, and they get brighter as you approach them, as you can see. So I beat Super Meat Boy a long time ago on the 360. And watching that stream kind of made me want to get back into it and see if I could actually, you know, make some headway in getting 100% or 106%, as the case might be. And I was really, the controls were frustrating me a lot more than, I mean, even more than they did last time. Because I beat the game, but I never thought I would be able to do, like, all the fidgety time trial stuff that you have to do to unlock the Dark World versions of each level, and actually get the true ending of the game. Okay, so every time you get a key, it gives you one of these. The game calls it a riddle, but it's really more like a trivia question. What is considered to be the most dangerous large animal in Africa? Well, polar bears aren't in Africa, and giraffes are not dangerous. Well, I guess they can be dangerous, but not as dangerous as hippos. I heard the hippos can be real assholes if you're not careful. So I will go and answer that, and I have the key now. Now, I haven't found out what happens when you get an answer wrong yet. I've only gotten a couple of keys in my playthrough. So I guess we'll find that out. Once you get a key, you just bring it back to a checkpoint, and it stores it. And now I have 29 keys left. Pretty simple. So, Super Meat Boy, I was actually making some progress in getting 100%. I got 100% in World 1. I managed to get an A+ on every level and find all the bandages, and I beat all the Dark World levels as well. But my controller, I mean, it was just so frustrating playing that game. And you guys know, I don't really get frustrated that easily, normally. When you go back and watch the VVVVVV stream, if you want to see evidence of that. And I think the problem is actually my controller. So I'm going to get a new controller and see if I can... Those who defy wizard shall be destroyed by a wizard or his minions. Oh, yeah, interesting. Hello, Majin Paul. Welcome to the chat room. By the way, I used to give shoutouts... Whoa, this guy's hunting me. I used to give shoutouts to everyone who came into the chat room. And I mentioned this in the Hotline Miami stream. I should have just gotten that checkpoint. I used to give shoutouts to everyone, but a friend of mine pointed out that that can be kind of creepy, because maybe you don't want to chat. Maybe you just want to poke your head in the stream, and if I say hello to you, you might feel like you're obligated to stick around and keep watching. So if you want to shout out, just say something in the chat room, and I will say hello to you. I kind of want to see what's up. This is the first enemy I've encountered that actually has AI, so to speak. Transport hub, eh? Interesting. Let's see, where the heck am I? Whoa, was there a key down there that I didn't get, or is that just pointing out that... Let me go back and double... Well, I can't go back. Okay, never mind. Well, let's head left. Haven't been there yet. So yeah, if you want to shout out... Oops. So that's what happens when you die. The explosion and the sound effect really reminds me of, Eversion, if you ever play that game. Another really good indie platformer. Whoa. Well, let's see, I can't go left from here. I'm trying to figure out if that exclamation point is just the key that I picked up, or if... Oh, no. Wow, I did not even see that when I came into this room. Okay. Well, let's go for another key then. Hello, Agent Rainer 96. How's it going? Alright, in what year did the Battle of Hastings take place? Okay, I got this question the little bit that I played earlier as well. Well, 2066 obviously isn't the answer, and I'm pretty sure 1966, there wasn't a war going on in Hastings at that time, so I'll go with B, 1066. Am I the only one who has this annoying commercial right on the chat room window? I haven't experienced anything like that, but I usually use Adblock, so if there are advertisements inhibiting your experience, I apologize. Everything will be posted on YouTube as well, so you can watch the video later on YouTube if you want to see the real deal. So yeah, Super Meat Boy, good game, kind of iffy controls. I think most of my problem with the game was because of my controller, so I will give it another shot, and I might stream some of my attempts, if you guys would be interested in that. Do not feed the testers by order of the wizard. Are these things testers? They remind me of an enemy from some game, but can't put my finger on what. Alright, no way to jump up here. So let's head right. So I noticed that I'm not getting as many people as normal as when I was doing the bi-weekly streams on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Which is kind of a bummer. These things really remind me of an enemy from Eversion as well. I really had fun doing the bi-weekly streams, and I might go back to having a regular schedule like that. But it just made doing it not as fun when I had like this very, It was a prison island, Alcatraz Island, also referred to as... Are these all Nicolas Cage movies? That's hilarious. I'm pretty sure it was The Rock, especially since the other two answers don't really make sense. Oh god. Oh god. Oh man. Okay, where's the closest checkpoint? Well, I'm pretty far back. I'll try going... Well, actually, let's try dropping down. See what's down there. So yeah, just feeling like I was obligated to do a stream at this specific time, you know, twice a week. I don't know, it made it a little less enjoyable for me, and I'm not really sure if that's, not really sure if it's because I felt pressure or what, but, or if I was just doing it too often. That might be an issue as well. The computer, the first beat chess champion, Garry Kasparov in 1997? Well, Deep Thought was the computer from The Hitchhiker's Guide. Don't know what Deep Hurting is. Pretty sure it's Deep Blue. Let's see. There's a checkpoint down and to the left. Let's see if I can... Let's see. Can't go left from here, so... Oh, shit. I hit the lava in the middle of the little grid there. Okay. So I wonder if that means I have to answer the trivia question again, or if it'll give me a different trivia question. Because so far, these are all questions that I got in the little brief time that I played. I think I got 4 keys. So I'm not sure if it is, if it's time-based, like, just the first question you get is always the first question you get, or if it mixes it up at all. Okay, yeah, same question. Deep Blue, okay. Talking about Cave Story in the chat room. That's a shame, Straight Line. Cave Story is a great game. I highly recommend giving it another chance. If the mood ever strikes you. Alright, so, still a lot of the world left to explore. Oops. Luckily I had a checkpoint, nearby. I thought about doing an LP or a stream of Cave Story, especially after I finally beat Balos and got the true final ending. Do not attempt to open the box. Oh, what box might you be referring to? That's odd. But Cave Story is a very... it's a game that has a lot of exposure. Like, there have been a lot of LPs and streams and speedruns and all that of the game. So I figure it's had its day. Let's see, orangutans are crazy orange apes that live in the jungle. What do they like to eat? I kind of want to say delicious human flesh just to see what happens when I get a question wrong. But no, it's fruit. I'm sure I'll get a question wrong naturally sooner or later. Let's head back and drop this key off before I die again. I'm not sure there is a reason to carry more than one key at a time. If there's a reason you'd ever have to do that. I guess, just if you're in an area where there aren't a lot of checkpoints. Vermin trouble. These things kind of look like anthropomorphic... Well, not anthropomorphic, but... They look like toilet paper rolls with a human face. So yeah, the music in this game is quite good. Well, a lot of it is. This tune, I don't know, it's okay. But a lot of the music in the game really reminds me of music in Psygnosis games, like Pugsy and Wiz and Liz. Whoa, it's snowy. Alright, looks like there's a barrier on the left and right hand sides of the world, so it doesn't wrap around like it does in VVVVVV. Almost an Oxbow corridor. I don't know what that means, but I wish Oxbow was here to see the shout out that he gets in this game. I don't know if Exergia still watches my stuff or not. I think I saw him in a recent stream, but I'm not 100% sure. Hope I can get a hold of him and get a copy of that script. Baggage claim. I get it. Oh, well, that didn't work out. Speaking of Psygnosis, they recently announced, well, I don't know who's actually in charge of the project, but someone's releasing, like, a USB stick containing remastered music from Psygnosis games. And unfortunately, it costs like $60, but it's like a 1 gig USB stick, and it's this really cool looking like owl, well, you know, the owl logo from Psygnosis. And it comes in this nice commemorative metal tin, and I think it's like a limited edition and all that fancy stuff. But it costs like $60, which is a little steep for me. Hoodlums in the Stairway. I guess that's what those things are. The Medusa heads over there are hoodlums. I have a strange desire to rewatch your Splatterhouse LP. Well, I don't know why, but hey, knock yourself out. That is not some of my best work. I don't know. I went through like this phase where I felt like I had to pretend to be angry. I mean, it wasn't really pretending, but like my reactions were not 100%. I mean, that's not how I react when I play video games. Like, the screaming and the cursing and all that. It's like I watched Angry Video Game Nerd, and I felt like I had to imitate that. And, like, the big LP trend. Ooh. Of, you know, people getting really angry and, you know, violent and cursing and all that. And, you know, that's just not me. I try not to do that anymore. If LaserCat had a sports car, what color would it be? Well, that's actually not a trivia question. That is a riddle. Well, I want to say red, because it is the most obvious color of a sports car. But that might be a trick question. What do you guys in the chat room think? Red, blue, or transparent? I'll go with the chat room wisdom on this. I think C says Majin Paul. Private Steve says C. Okay. Let's try C and see what happens. Oh, okay. Apparently that was a correct answer. Weird. And the music got sinister all of a sudden, and everything's all red and evil looking. Infected window box. It was the only option different from the other two. Well, it's the only option that wasn't actually a color. I mean, I don't know what the logic there is, but glad I got it right. How would you even get a transparent car in real life? Well, you know, you'd have to have one special, you know, custom made. Just call up Dr. Ferrari on the phone and be like, "Yo, Doc, I have a special project for you." You know, Dr. Ferrari, the president of Ferrari, the car company. Oh, it's another ghost cat. The chains of fate watch over us all. Okay, buddy. So yeah, the reason I started playing this game is because a friend of mine who streams under the name Zen Machine Gun put together a list of like 90 games that she recommended. And I was just going through because I was in the mood for... I've been in the mood for a platformer, but I didn't really know what kind. Like, I wanted something like VVVVVV, which is actually what made me check this game out. But I didn't realize, was there a key up there that I missed? Apparently the exclamation points disappear when you pick the key up because they're all gone except for that one. But when I played the game, or when I decided to get the game, because it was only $2, I didn't realize how much like VVVVVV it was going to be. But you know, I'm pleasantly surprised by it. I'm okay with that. I mean, the main point of VVVVVV is the mechanic. you know, the gravity flipping thing. Oh yeah, it's that one. And I haven't been able to get in there yet. So yeah, if a game ripped off the mechanic of VVVVVV, I'd be a lot more critical of it. But, you know, just copying the general C64 kind of look of the game, I'm okay with that. And having a name for every level or every screen. Which, you know, VVVVVV didn't even... It wasn't even the first game to do that. That's a reference to, I believe Jetpack Willy was the game. So... Just because VVVVVV kind of referenced it first, it was the first thing in recent, the first game in recent days to do something like that. I guess it kind of gets the credit for that. No death mode is impossible. Yes, I would never attempt to play VVVVVV in no death mode. That's a... That game... It's kind of cumbersome to say that game's name all the time. From now on, I'm just going to refer to it as V6 in casual conversation. These things look kind of like aversion enemies as well. The most important part of the game is not being boring. If the game succeeds at that, it can be about anything. Yeah, I agree, Majin Paul, but there are limits to how derivative you want a game to be. But this is fine, I think. The creator definitely added his own... Oops. Well, I didn't realize that would happen. Although I guess I should have realized it. You know, let's head up. I haven't been up from here yet. Oh, there's another key in there. Oh, wait. That was the owl. Holy shit. Owl's cell right below us. Oh. The only thing that wizard fears is that dang duck. Put ducks on holiday, as it says in the name of the screen. I really love this track. This really reminds me of Psygnosis games. It's quite good. I don't know who did the music in this game. I guess it would tell you if you looked at the credits. You need to have stored every key before you can face the mighty wizard. Well, I kind of assume that. Oh hey, Sore Thumb, what's up? Duke, have you played Altered Beast? I have, many, many years ago. Well, there's Al. And we still have 24 keys left to find. I don't know why we need all those keys, there's only two locks here. Was out and also watching that popular speedrun thing. Oh yeah, awesome games done quick. Oops. I guess it probably wasn't a great idea. That might be another reason why there aren't that many people here. Probably wasn't a great idea to do streams while AGDQ was going on. I've been watching some of that, mostly just games that I care about. I watched the blind Punch-Out speedrun. Well, he didn't beat it blind, but he made it pretty goddamn far while blindfolded. Some dude was blindfolded and played Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, and he got really far in the game. He got farther than I've been in the game with eyesight. It's pretty crazy. Then he took the blindfold off and proceeded to completely pummel the game. Yeah, literally blindfolded. Had it wrapped around his eyes. And I watched the Super Meat Boy speedrun. I didn't realize you could get crushed. The shadow remains cast. And I watched the Super Meat Boy speedrun, which made me want to play Super Meat Boy again, which I talked about a little earlier. And I played the Binding of Isaac Reign of SOTN. I think he's been in the streams a couple times. And I mean, it wasn't really a speedrun per se, but it was still a pretty good run. Mars is the Roman god of war, but who is the Greek god of war? Well, that would be Ares. B. Alright, well, there's a checkpoint right below me, so I think I will drop down. Let's head left. Have not been left yet. Err? I still need to get Super Meat Boy. Yeah, it's a fun game. I'm still not 100% sold on the controls. But like I said, I will get a new controller and give it another try and let you know if my opinion changed. You're so smart, Duke. Well, it's not really smartness as much as it is. I'm a pretty big trivia nerd, I guess. I like Trivial Pursuit, and I like trivia shows and quiz shows and stuff. I mean, I'm not dumb, but, you know, knowledge is not equal to intelligence. Ooh. Sudden music change. Oh. Wizard refuses to switch to digital is how they get you. That's pretty cute. This map is huge, Duke. Yeah, it's pretty big. I think 255 screens or something. Uh-oh. And I haven't really shown off warping yet, so now that I have plenty of checkpoints, you can warp to any of the green squares. Can anyone recommend me some good PS3 games? My friend gifted me this useless box and I don't know what to play on it. Well, I don't have a PS3, but there are plenty of great multi-platform games that I could recommend. Well, first of all, Eco Shadow of the Colossus Collection. I played Eco and Shadow of the Colossus on the PS2, and they're among my favorite games. Kind of wish I had a PS3 just so I can check that out. They took my eyes. I need them for chess club. I feel like that's a reference to something. I feel like that reminds me of something. Can't put my finger on what. Which was the first animal to enter Earth's orbit? Oh, that would be Lake of the Dog. Vladimir the Bear. They should have sent a bear into orbit. The very first living creature in orbit. That would have been awesome. Gutter Trash. Journey for the PS3, yeah, that's another game that makes me wish I had a PS3. Rooftop Aerobics. Oh man, Ghost Cat. All hail Wizard, or else. The sign isn't just for show. Well, thank you for telling me, Ghost Cat. So I read a book recently called John Dies at the End. It's written by this guy. Oh, shit. Go home, LaserCat. That's not very nice. It's written by this guy named David Wong, who recently kind of became famous for this article that he wrote. He's a writer on Cracked.com, and he wrote this article that was like 6 harsh truths that will make you a better person or something like that. And I enjoyed the article, so I decided to check out some of his other stuff. And John Dies at the End was a novel that he wrote, kind of in serialized form. Oh, new quiz question. Where did the Aztec people live? Aside from the obvious Aztec houses, that would have been Mesoamerica, eh? But John Dies at the End is kind of a horror comedy novel. Someone I know. I forgot to brush my gums. I'll never get another chance. Brush your teeth every day. Good advice. But John Dies at the End, someone described it as a mashup of H.P. Lovecraft and Hunter S. Thompson, which I guess is kind of accurate. It wasn't as good as I was hoping it would be based on that description, but it was still pretty entertaining. I would recommend it. It was kind of a mess, though, like plot-wise. If I have 15 apples in one hand and 12 in the other, what do I have? Large hands. Well, 12 plus 15 is not 20 or 1. So I guess C must be the answer. What happens if you fail a question? Yeah, I haven't failed one yet, so I'm not sure. But anyway, the way John dies at the end came into existence, it's kind of a good story, because the author, David Wong, not his real name, he actually had the same job that I have. He did data entry, but for a law firm instead of the government like I do. And he had this website called pointlesswasteoftime.com that he did in his free time just as a hobby. And it started with just like a really short story. And, you know, word of mouth kind of spread and the story became popular and he expanded on it from there. But, you know, eventually it turned into a book, and now the book was made into a movie. Which is awful, by the way. The movie is not a good representation of the book. Not recommended. And the book, a sequel came out for the book recently. And it's pretty inspiring that this dude... Oh, shit. That this dude just kind of started writing, put his stuff out on this website, and it blew up to, you know, such a huge level. But since the book was kind of pieced together from... You know, I mean, basically a series of vignettes. That's the reason the plot isn't really that coherent. But it's still pretty entertaining. Duke, you heard that Pokemon XY got announced. I did. I never really was into the Pokemon games, so... was not that excited about it. But a lot of people seem to be excited about it, which is good. I'm really surprised that the next Pokemon game is a 3DS game and not a Wii U game. Because, man, if they made a Pokemon game for the Wii U with, like, online multiplayer and everything, the Wii U would blow up. It would sell more than it has. Not that it's been a failure, but it hasn't been as hot as the Wii was. But man, if they made like a Pokemon, not an MMO, but like, I mean, basically stick to the formula of Pokemon, but let you do everything online and like make a big, fancy 3D, you know, environment, because that's what people want, right? But no, Pokemon XY looks like a pretty typical Pokemon game. The point of Pokemon is to be portable. Yeah, I know, but. They've made non-portable Pokemon games before. I mean, there was Pokemon Snap and Hey You Pikachu, so it wouldn't be unprecedented. Okay, let's see. Where should I go? I haven't been right yet. The other less cool party. Apparently there's a cool party that I missed. Never did figure out how to get that key over to the right, did I? I think when I find a checkpoint, I'm going to teleport over there and see if I can figure it out. Oops. Well, that didn't work. I mean, the Pokemon games aren't bad. I just never really got into them. It kind of blew up right after I was no longer the age that it appealed to. If that makes any sense. Like, when I became a teenager, Pokemon was blowing up with the younger generation. Move along. Alright, let's warp over here and see if we can figure this out. Whoa. If I got the checkpoint, why did I not go right before? That's weird. This music is familiar. Yeah, I mean, none of it is like... I mean, it sounds like Lemmings, but it's not like a direct ripoff of any Lemmings music. It's just very similar. Pro end, go up. Oh, apparently I should go up. Hey, what's going on, Just Drop? I wasn't sure if you'd make it or not. I wasn't sure if you left for your job assignment yet or not. Glad you can make it, dude. Just Drop recently did a stream of the end of Torchlight 2, and me and Mors Draconis were there as well. It was fun, but I kind of wouldn't expect anyone not into Torchlight to be interested in it. Since it was just us playing, we weren't really explaining what was going on or anything. But it was a good time. Should velociraptors have feathers? Opinion-based trivia questions are dumb. Oh, wow. What do you think, chat room? A, B, or C? I mean, I would say B. Sore thumb thinks B. Okay, let's go for B. Oh, apparently that was correct. Anger can be managed without the use of architecture. The angry dumb. I get it. I wonder if those questions, if it's even possible to get them wrong, or if they're just in there for the humor value. If the asker is asking the question, the last thing they want is to be marginalized or told they're stupid for asking. Yeah, but if the developer put it in there, he probably knew what he was doing. Alright, 19 keys left to go. We are moving right along here. This game seems to take itself just a tad serious for this. I don't think it takes itself seriously at all. If anyone finds the keys, leave them on my desk, W. Apparently W stands for wizard. I don't know why I'm trying to jump up there. It doesn't look like there's anything there. But I have no idea if there are any secrets or anything in this game. Well, other than the ghost cats, which are kind of secret. Can I even go left from here? I don't think so. I bet this game could be a total dick and only show you your wrong answers at the end. Aw, man, that would suck. If I just didn't know when I was getting a question wrong. Yeah, there's no way I can jump up there. Okay, well, let's find a different direction to go then. Maybe down, and then circle back around left. Engineer's break room. I guess those things are the engineers. They look kind of like Bertato from the webcomic. If any of you have ever read that, Nedroid. Really awesome webcomic, I recommend it. Alright, I've been here before. So in this next room, I need to go up instead of left. Right? Yes. Oops. No, don't exit for reals. Oh, Domokun, yeah. Yeah, it does kind of look like that as well. Duct cleaners. I can't go up from here, unfortunately. Unless I can land on those things or something. Which I don't think I can. They do look like they have kind of a flat top, so let's try it. Nope. Okay. I didn't notice that your ghost kind of floats up like that when you die. What's a duct? It's like a pipe that air moves through. Like if you have an air conditioner, the air moves through a duct. Well, huge area down in the lower right that I haven't explored yet. I wonder if there's any way... Well, let's try something. Oh, that worked. Okay, awesome. I wasn't sure if it would sweep me to the left or not. Okay. Well, that didn't really take me anywhere cool. I realize where I've heard this music before. Do tell, Straightline. Cats for Justice. Whoa! Telekinetic plates. We love Wizard. In a gulag on the moon. Now this sounds like the kind of thing I could actually get wrong. I'm gonna go with an Italian prison, just because I don't think dungeons are actually used anymore. Like, even in the Vatican. Okay, that worked out. I mean, I know the Vatican is kind of backwards, but even they probably don't have dungeons still. Hope I don't land on something unpleasant. Robot hangar opening. Man, this dude loves his pound sterling. That is like his unit of currency of preference. Okay, well this area is completely new. Kinda wanna drop my key off before I take my chances down there. No dungeons in the Vatican? Yeah, that's what I figured. I guess I can go on ahead and grab this key, as long as I'm here. And you can hold more than one key at a time. The first mancraft to land on the moon? It's either B or C. Voyager wasn't manned, it was Apollo 11. I'm dumb. Okay. Did the color scheme just change? I don't think everything was this red and menacing before. Maybe the color scheme changes when I get it wrong. Whoa. No, it looks like it just kind of changes at will. This area seems a bit dangerous. Oh god. For some reason, I didn't think those things would move through those little walls there. Okay, well that sucks. That's a pretty significant hunk of backtracking I have to do. Alright, well, I'll just do what I did before. Get blown out of the exhaust pipe there. Sorry, guys. I wasn't paying a ton of attention. Helipad. Nice. Oh god. I think last time I went a different direction that made it easier to dodge the telekinetic plates. Alright, this time I'll just hang left. Oh, by the way, I don't know why he's called LaserCat yet. I haven't found anything that would indicate that there's a laser in this game. Oh, hey, Sergio, what's up? I was hoping you'd make it. I wanted to ask you about the script that you made that lets me convert the chat room to YouTube subtitles. Because the website where you were hosting that doesn't exist anymore. And I was wondering if there was any way you could, like, I don't know, give me the script or something so I could upload it to my own website. Or upload it somewhere else. Oh yeah. I almost picked the wrong answer. Which again, I kind of want to, just to see what happens when you do. Alright, this is the way I went before. I'll check, thanks. Really appreciate the script, by the way. It's made my videos a lot more interesting. I think, anyway. Steel rain. Alright, Apollo 11. Nailed it. Hopefully you don't just die outright if you get an answer wrong. That would kind of suck. Oh, I earned an achievement for that. Store 3 keys at the same time. Awesome. Alright, well, let's head back down and get this key that we missed because we died. It allowed the general public to see how insane you guys are. Well, mostly just you, just drop. But yeah, some of the other chatters as well. Mind the step. What the hell? Let's see what's down. Now, this is the bottom right-hand corner of the world. Secret temple? This doesn't seem very secret. Alright, new question. The first motion picture to contain zombies. Well, I know White Zombie was a movie, because Rob Zombie named the band White Zombie after it. I don't know if it was before or after Night of the Living Dead, though. I think I'll go with B. Oh! Picked the wrong answer for a riddle. Wise from your grave. So, it just teleports you to the wrong answer room. Okay. Well, that's good to know. Let's see. Should be pretty easy to get back there. Do you have the brains for this puzzle? Alright, there's definitely A then. Okay, good deal. While they were zombies, they didn't call them zombies. It's possible. I should be able to do this. This is the trickiest platforming in the game so far. So yeah, White Zombie, the first motion picture to contain zombies. Interesting. My streams are entertaining and educational. Well, mostly just this one. I wanted a lot of pickled eggs. Which of these would have the most? 2 dozen, a score, or half a gross? Well, gross is 144. Half of that would be 92. 2 dozen is 24. And I think a score is only like 20. So I'm pretty sure it's C. Half a gross. Excellent. I am the master. I really like how the game incorporates trivia into just a normal exploration platformer. But, you know, I'm a trivia nerd. I would definitely play more games like this if they existed. Oh, good, checkpoint. Oh, this room looks on the tricky side. Why is it called a gross? So they named it after you, straight line. Ooh, burn. I'm just kidding. You're not gross. Your owl friend loves to eat marshmallows, but what do real owls tend to eat? Small mammals. Mice, ferrets, stoats. Well, you had to see that coming, straight line. I could not make that joke. Well, quote unquote joke. Quack, quack, quack. Which of these species of duck? Which of these is a species of duck? Well, a mallard just means a male duck. An emperor is a penguin. So I'm assuming it's the Galapagos. What? Huh. That was weird. Maybe... Isn't a mallard just a male duck? I might have been misinformed. Or maybe Emperor is a duck too. I don't know. Oops, shit. Damn it. Yeah, I turned those keys in at the checkpoint. So I didn't lose any progress on that one. I did not have any difficulty with this the first time. There we go. Anyone see the Indiana Jones reference? I don't think so. I haven't seen the Indiana Jones movies in a long time. Oh, yes, I did. Okay. So that's one key I lost. Unless penguins equal ducks. I don't think so. Well, what do you guys think? Emperor or Mallard? Just Drop says Mallard. He's pretty trustworthy. I'll go with him. Okay. Well, apparently I was wrong. I thought a Mallard just meant a male duck. Kind of like a rooster, but for ducks. Alright, where to now? Well, a lot of options. Aw, I wanted him to explode. BRB. Alright. Monkey Lab X13. Testing the effects of lava on primates. Now, why isn't our government researching that sort of thing? Said right. Yeah, the key total might appear to keep going up and down because when you die, obviously the key's left. Will revert back to its previous state. No, not much here. I think I'm gonna head back to the left. Hello, Chimera573. Welcome to the chat room. Oh man. I have knives waiting in the wings. I have knives flipping around. Second stage of the five stages of grief. Ice World. Well, bargaining is like towards the end. It's almost the last. So I'm pretty sure it's anger. I like this dude's sense of humor. It reminds me of my own. Wonder if he's made any other games. He or she, I guess. I don't know anything about the person who made this game. Hive Town. Waste Pile. Let's keep heading along the bottom. See if there's anything in that section of the map. Oh, hi Ghost. Tourists should be careful while on holiday. Good advice for anyone, I think. Well, anyone on holiday. Oh, shit. There's a lava ceiling there. Alright. Alien tech storage. Ooh, that was some alien tech. Temple of Ziox. Okay. Hockey Hair is a mullet, which I only know because of the Vandal song, I've Got an Ape Drape. Oh man. Can I get across without going up? That looks tough. Awesome. I don't know if I really need to do this, but that was still pretty impressive. I deserve a medal for that one. Or possibly a trophy. Let's go down. Ooh. That key's gonna be hard to get. Sewer level. Oops. I died. Alright, let's head down from here, I guess. Oops. That's what I get for looking at the chat. Okay, let's go left. If I wrap this up fairly quickly, I might play a quick game of The Binding of Isaac. Just for old time's sake. How long has it been? An hour? Okay. Shouldn't take me longer than another hour or so to finish this. I'm just gonna head down, since that's where I ended up heading anyway. Oh man, we got conveyor belts, we have one-way walls, lots of platforming conventions. They eat ants, termites, and are pretty ard. But what are aardvarks also known as? Ant buru and goblins or ant bears? I thought it was just ant eaters. I have no idea. Ant bear sounds pretty likely. Okay. Huh, I didn't know that. I just thought it seemed logical because of like ant lions, like a big animal that eats ants. Kind of made sense. Haven't actually played The Binding of Isaac in like 6 months. I've played on and off. I still haven't, actually, I haven't streamed in a really long time. I haven't streamed since I got Golden God. So I've been trying to do what I need to get Platinum God, but I have not yet been able to even come close to beating the chest. The chest is very difficult, if not impossible. Do I want to head up, or do I want to keep trying to head down? What's down? Okay. Can't fall down there. Let's teleport down here. See if I can head left. Haven't been in that direction yet. The pit. Do not think I can jump across that. Oh, I was mistaken. I've been wrong before. Let's go down. Pathfinding doesn't work. He's lying, he plays it every day. No, I don't play The Binding of Isaac that often. But yeah, feel free to add me to Steam though. Everyone, my name is Duke the Bump. Actually, add me to Desura too if you have that. Now that I own Desura, the name is also Duke of the Bump. Okay, I cannot go up from this room, so that is not a direction that would help me get the key. Ooh, this looks promising. Let's see. Well, let's go up. Trapezoid steps. Yeah, it's kind of trapezoidal. Trapezoidal doesn't sound right. Sounds like it should be trapezoidal or something like that. But that does not sound right either. Excellent. There's a ghost cat there too. And the tale of Jason and the Argonauts, what was the giant Talos made from? Gold, delicious human flesh, or bronze? Huh. Well, that was like ancient Roman times. So bronze would have been more common than gold. But of course it's a movie, so it does not have to make sense. I want to go with bronze. Okay. The lava isn't made of delicious candy. Oh, good to know. I have seen Jason and the Argonauts. I was extremely young. I was like 8 years old and watching it on TV. And I remember even back then how cheesy I thought the claymation and stuff looked. But of course, that movie came out in like the 50s or the 60s or something. So I guess it was pretty awesome for the time. Damn it, go up. Well, I have this one square off to the right here. Oh, glad I came this way. I have a checkpoint and a key. Let's go ahead and drop that off. Which mythological beings are also known as lycanthropes? Well, that would be werewolves. Too easy. Okay, I have this tiny little section off to the left that I haven't filled in yet, because of course I'm going to have to fill in every square on the map, because that's the kind of guy I am. So let's go ahead and grab that while we're over here. If I can. There might be a reason I didn't go over there before. I wish I could use those teleporters. But I guess my teleporters are even better. Oh, that's the entrance. Okay. Well, let's teleport up here and see if I can figure out. Can I go down from here? Yeah, I can. Okay. I just didn't before for some reason. Okay, no keys in either of those locations. Look at him gloat when he was stumped on ducks. Well, you know, Just Drop, I've only gotten 2 answers wrong the whole game. So I think I'm doing pretty well. Actually, let's go down here and see if I can fill in this tiny little section. See, I keep thinking I can just go down from here and come out on top, but the world doesn't wrap around in this game. Okay. So yeah, head left from here. I'm just messing with you. I know. I'm just playing along. Wow, this looks tough. Okay. Whew. This also looks tough. Wait, are these deadly or just that color? Oh, okay. I thought those were deadly lava blocks. That's slightly confusing. Because I've definitely seen lava blocks. They look very similar to that. Bin the cats. Bins are scary, call the newspapers. So yeah, person who made this game, definitely British. Alright, let's go up and get that tiny section up here before I... And then I'll get that big section towards the middle. And then I'll start worrying about the two big sections. British people rule, like me. Yeah, British people are pretty cool. I know a lot of cool Brits. Rooftop meanies. Red meanies instead of blue meanies. Alright, nothing interesting there. Whoa. I can head left from here? Isn't that where the owl is? I'm confused. Okay. Okay. Let us teleport. Let's head down here. Lots of areas down here to explore. Fuzzy logic. I like giving every screen its own name. Really adds character to the game, I think. Okay. Nothing new over here. Let's see if I can get around these wind-up Moai heads. That's how you pronounce that, right? Moai? M-A-U-I? I will serve you tea and put Visine in it, sir. I don't know what that means, but it doesn't sound very pleasant. One tiny little square down there that I didn't get. It's gonna drive me nuts if I don't go for it. Makes you sick. Well, I imagine that was for straight line. Yeah, I know, but I'm not. Oh, because he was a smartass when you asked where Majin Paul was from. I get it. Okay, I think I see a way to get to that square that I haven't gotten. I mean, normally... Oh, I can't go up there. Damn it. Normally I wouldn't make a huge deal out of it, but... You know, there might be a key there. And I'd really hate it if that's the one key that I'm missing at the end of the game. And I just... Okay, there wasn't a key there. Okay, let's teleport here. That looks good. Oh, okay. It's that place. Let's teleport here. Whoa. That looks super dangerous. Oh man, it's like a forced catapult. I was gonna say it's like an endless runner kind of stage. Oops. Robot cat attack. Cat saves the world. Let's see, you have Catabolt, you have Robot Cat Attack, do you have Cat Jetpack Cat Ride, the Impossible Cat? Auto-scrolling platform game. Yay! That worked out pretty well. Did you pay attention during optician class? Which animal has the largest eyes on Earth? Killer Eye Beasts. I'm pretty sure it's the giant squid. At least one of us made it to the end alive. Well, you know, after a couple tries. I was going to go to the checkpoint, but I don't really want to drop down there yet. Oh, well, that was pleasant. Hey, dude. Alright, only 8 keys left to go. Aw, I wanted to go left there. Because I haven't been to that screen yet. Oh, there's a key there, too. Good. Oops! I forgot that was a conveyor belt. Oops. I didn't realize he was going to turn around there. Alright, what's the easiest way to get back to the key? Just, I guess, go this way again. Actually, let's go ahead and grab that checkpoint. Just in case I die again. Make it a little bit easier to get back there. Kulfi is a type of Indian food, but what kind? Curry, dinosaur bacon, or ice cream? Well, I mean, curry would be the obvious answer. I don't think ice cream is that common in India, but I could be completely wrong. Well, it was ice cream. Oh, sorry, sore thumb. Too late. You gotta have it at a restaurant if you haven't. Sore thumb's chastising me on Steam. It's not that big a deal, dude. We're just one screen away. Alright. Definitely dinosaur bacon. No, it's ice cream. Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and drop my key off. Then I think I'm gonna head back to the left. Cause there's some, I think there's a way I can go down. And there are a couple blocks there that I haven't explored yet. Yeah, there we go. The prize. Well, that block's not going to come all the way over here. I guess I have to approach it from the right-hand side. I guess that's the one bad thing about trivia games. Because when I do get something wrong, I look like a dummy. A dumbo. But it's all in good fun. Alright. Let's head up. Well, see if I can head left from here. See if I can push, fight against the current, so to speak. Don't push me. I think this is what I'm supposed to do here. Well, maybe. I don't know. Oh no, don't push me, just referring to that little block there in the middle of the area. Okay. This is just meant to sweep me back if I fall off, I think. I need to come over here and then, yeah, there we go. Let's hit that checkpoint real quick. Final boss is out for lunch. Oh, good. I don't think you were really adult. I know. It's all in good fun. That's disorienting as hell. Sorry. I thought maybe there was going to be a trick to it. I like the little halo effect that's always around the cat. I guess that's why they call him Laser Cat. Because it looks kind of like the dot of a laser pointer. Maybe. I don't know. It makes it easy to always see where on the screen you are. Which I guess isn't that big of a deal, but it's a nice touch. If I was acrophobic, what would I be scared of? Well, heights is agoraphobic. Uppercase letters. Pretty sure it's crowds. Oh no, agoraphobic is like big wide open areas. Okay. I'm sorry. I know several of you were probably shouting at your screen. Because, yeah, acrophobic like an acrobat. It makes sense. I wouldn't be surprised if there is a fear of uppercase letters, though. There are some pretty strange phobias out there. How do you know this? Knowing is half the battle, my friend. Had a little bit of control difficulty there. It's kind of janky when you're moving. When you're on a moving platform like that. Oops. I wonder if this is a Game Maker game. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with Game Maker or anything. People have made some pretty cool games with them. The first Barclay Shut Up and Jam was Game Maker, I think. Yeah, on the vertical platforms, it's a little janky. Stuff like that makes me wonder if it was made with Game Maker. Which, you know, good on them if it was, because this is a pretty decent game. I'd say I've gotten my $2 worth. I have no idea what they're talking about in the chat room. Something about lava and liquids, superheated liquids or something. This game was made in Game Maker. No, I'm just wondering if it was. Alright, heights. Because there are little bits of jank that makes it, kind of gives me that impression. Aw, man, I want to just drop down so I can get to that checkpoint, but I don't want to risk falling on something deadly. Alright, I should be able to get my way, make my way over to that checkpoint from here. I'm close enough. Okay, there we go. Alright, only 6 keys to go. Let's head down. I haven't been down yet. Or have I? Do they know how the other feels? That's a reference to a song, isn't it? Pink Floyd song? Sounds familiar. Core Blimey, a question approaches. What birds are required to stay at the Tower of London? Oh. Well, I doubt it's flamingos. I'm gonna go with ravens. Oh, awesome. Robins don't seem like a bird you really associate with England that much. Damn it! See, when you're on a vertical platform, it gets a little iffy. Yeah, we are nerds. Well, that's a requirement to be in my stream, Majin Paul, so don't worry about it. Alright, ravens, yep. Alright, let's see if I can do this without dying now. There we go. Head up to the checkpoint where I know it's safe, or try to keep going. I'll try to push on. I'll probably be okay. I start freaking out when I have a key. Play things extremely carefully. Wind tunnel control. Well, there's no chance of me getting past these guys. So let's fall down. See what happens. Oh, checkpoint. Awesome. Five more. Whoa. Existential nightmare room. That doesn't sound good. That doesn't sound good at all. Well, I guess that's all it was. Just a big, empty, silent room. Alright, let's head down and then try to head left. Because there's a screen that I haven't gotten there. I actually like that there's not so much people on the stream so that we can all chat between ourselves and the streamer. Yeah, I wouldn't want too many people, but I don't know. I'd say about 10 to 20 is a pretty good balance. Test chamber. Man, that thing's going to drop down on me, isn't it? I feel like a nerd now. Well, you are a nerd, just drop. You play video games and talk to the internet while you do it. What is a young kangaroo called, Joey? Easy. Okay. Let's keep heading left. Oh god. The conveyor belt was moving in the other direction. If you have like 50 people, just flood the chat. Yeah, but if there were that many, then, you know, the moderators would help out with keeping things under control. I'll say this much. Do not watch the chat room on the twitch.tv channel for Awesome Games Done Quick. It is the worst, most shitty cesspool of internet idiots I have ever seen. Oh my god. If you do watch Awesome Games Done Quick, which I recommend, there's some cool stuff, go to their website, which is marathon.speeddemosarchive.com, and go to the chat room there. Under no circumstances should you go to the Twitch chat room. Because there were like 30,000 people watching at once. And obviously there aren't that many people in the chat room, but there's still thousands. And all of them, 99% of them, are complete idiots. I did the same thing. I donate when they do the cancer thing. Yeah, that's what they're doing now. Like J-Man stream, if I can bring him up here. Well, yeah, why wouldn't you be able to bring J-Man up here? We're buds. And yeah, his chat room can get a little out of control sometimes, but you know, the mods. The mods keep things under control for the most part. I suck at speedruns. Me too. Which is another reason I was kind of hesitant about playing Super Meat Boy and trying to get 100%. Because it requires you to basically speedrun the levels in order to get the dark levels. But I've been able to do it so far. Alright, let's head down. There's a checkpoint right down there. Alright, not much of the map left to explore. Are there any people you don't want brought up? Well, Hitler. Because if you bring up Hitler, you know, because of Godwin's Law and all that, it pretty much brings an end to the conversation. I don't know why I even tried that. It's not like I'll be able to go up there. I brought him up, ban. Oh, shit. I guess I did bring him up. Godwin's Law, everybody. Okay. So that's that little screen that I still needed to get. Alright, I need to go to this big horizontal corridor up above me. I tried TAS running Gunstar Heroes on Expert, didn't go well. Well, TAS is a little bit different. A TAS, or Tool Assisted Speedrun, is just a perfect playthrough of the game with emulators and stuff that help you accomplish that. What they do at Awesome Games Done Quick is it is live speedruns, which it's a little more interesting, I think. You know, it's people playing games very skillfully. Feed me. Uh-oh. Croco slugs need love too, but mostly they need food. Let's head left. Conduit. Okay. So I've been there, let's head right. Is that the Croco slug? The thing up in the corner? Because if so, I'm not impressed. Microcosm. Oh, hey, ghost cat. What's up? I found out the hard way that cats are delicious. Oh, maybe this is all building up to the croco slug. Lol poop. Yeah, this looks like it's building up to something. Waste control supervisors. Oh, well, maybe not. Man, there's nothing here? That sucks. I was expecting something big. But yeah, when it comes to speedruns, I mean, TASs can be cool, but it's not really as impressive as just a live speedrun. At least I don't think. The racetrack. Yeah, no reason to go up here. So let's continue going left. These things remind me of Grim Fandango. The art style of the skeleton dude. I don't know what his name is. I've never played that game. Sorry. I probably should. Going up the wrong escalator. Aw, man. Bad, bad bathhouse. That's a Persona 4 reference. I think. Unless that was referencing something else. Oh, Kostya, what's up? Welcome to the chat room. Thanks for coming. Let's warp here. Since there are several directions here that I can still go. Up or right. Well, I guess that's two, not several. Have I decided on a new controller yet? Not yet. I'm kind of thinking I might just get a new PS2 controller. Because I really like the PS2 controller. Just mine's really old. And the D-pad's probably starting to wear out. And I have an adapter for it. Anyway. So depending on how expensive they are, I might just go that route. The floor and ceiling are lava. I've used a wire 360 controller. Well, I have a wireless 360 controller. And they're good. I just don't really care for the D-pad on them. I mean, they're great if you're just using the dual analog sticks. But as far as the D-pad goes, this doesn't feel good to me. I don't know why I'm having so many issues with these vertical platforms. They're not that hard. This looks like it might potentially be challenging. Oh, well, I can't fucking go that way anyway. I'll have to approach that from the other side. Okay. Let's hit the checkpoint. Mazes and monsters. Wasn't that an early D&D knockoff? Mazes and monsters instead of Dungeons and Dragons. Okay, I can't go down to the left. Go-go fairy block. Hey, ghosty. Look and listen both ways before crossing the room. This game is just chock full of excellent advice. Danger, eh? Don't jump into the toilet even if you dropped your phone. I'm pretty lucky. I've never dropped my phone into the toilet. And I've never dropped it and broken it. Any of my phones. Well, I'm lucky and I handle them very carefully. Well, there's no point in going right from here since I've already been that way. Okay, let's head back. Actually, it'd be quicker to just kill myself. But I'll do it the honorable way. How the heck? Wonder how I drop down into that. Cause that's how. Oops. That's how I'm gonna have to end up getting that key. Thank you. I do kind of wonder if there's more to the game than this. There's like a boss or anything. Or any power-ups. Is there a laser at any point in the game? Or was I right? Does the laser just reference that halo effect around you? Verticality. Awesome. Because, I mean, it's a really cute game. I guess I shouldn't expect that much for $2. What's so laser about this cat? I haven't figured it out yet. Which bird has the ability to rotate its neck 270 degrees in either direction? I'm pretty sure that's the owl. I've seen owls do that before. Yeah. I like how British people call vegetables veg. Oh, great, now I have to get back there. God darn it. I like veg, but I don't like how they refer to math in the plural. It's like, oh yes, I've been studying maths. I don't know, that's kind of weird. I know it's short for mathematics, so it makes sense, technically. It just, it doesn't sound right to me. But veg, on the other hand, that's a great abbreviation. British people are really good at abbreviating things. Man, do I want to... I just want to go left. And get to that checkpoint over there. Since that's kind of the way I have to go anyway. Aw, man. Okay, actually, let's teleport. Let's go here and head up. I know I haven't been that way yet. It might not be that easy to head up from here, but I'll see if I can work my way up there. Ah, there we go. Can't jump up there. Really glad there's no momentum when you jump on a conveyor belt. That would make things annoying. Maths, that's kind of like the norm. Yeah, I know, but not in the US straight line. Sounds weird to our American ears. Shoot the tubes, cat meat. That's a reference to Super Shark. On the Sega CD. Probably tons of references in this game that I'm not getting. Mars has two small moons orbiting it. Which one of these isn't one of them? Inferno, see. Pretty easy. Pretty easy game. Yeah, let's head left. Because there's a checkpoint over here. Well, might be easier to get to the one down here. Alright, hate to do this, but I have to use the restroom. Can't wait. I will be right back. Okay, where was I? Stop talking about lava, says Straight Line. Yeah, the chat room's been talking about lava for, like, the last hour. I don't know what's so fascinating about lava. Alright, let's head right. Get this little pocket here that I haven't gotten yet. Exit port G. I have to say, this is a pretty elaborate castle. Wizard's a pretty cool dude. Let's keep going right. Hop to victory. Indeed. Hop, LaserCat. For everlasting justice. Actually, looks like I need to go up to get that key that I haven't gotten yet. Maybe not. Alright, I probably have to approach it from the right. So I will continue going right. Oh. Interesting. Apparently the giraffe is a vampire's favorite animal. Well, yeah, it makes sense. Well, with the neck and all. What color is a giraffe's tongue when it's alive and not drinking paint? I actually know that one. It's blue. And the reason I know that one is because of the television show Salute Your Shorts. It was an old Nickelodeon show from like the early 90s, like 92, 93 or something, I think. Might have been a little bit later. But one of the episodes had a radio call-in contest, and that was a question in the show. What color is a giraffe's tongue? Duke, could you explain to us the mechanics of your toilet? Well, Majin Paul, it has many fascinating machinations. Actually, it's not that fascinating. I'm not kidding around here, you don't want to fall in there. Oops. I didn't want to go that way. Oh. Achievement unlocked. Ignored a safety warning. Is that what that said? Can I see my achievements from here? No, I guess not. I ignored the sign and I got an achievement for it. I didn't do it on purpose. Garbage grinder. And it's a pretty sad existence these things must live. Aw, man, I want to keep going left, but I can't go left. Okay, I can go left here. Well, no, I've been here before too. This is I need to go down. No? Okay. I got it. I'm almost there. Seriously, be careful. Aw, I can't go left. Alright, let's head down. That room was called Pointless Platform. That's pretty good. Those things really look like an enemy from Eversion. I mean, it might be a deliberate, you know, nod to Eversion. Kind of like how in Super Meat Boy, you can unlock characters from other famous indie games. Damn it! I probably went about doing that the wrong way. Okay. I remember you being in this room earlier. Yeah, I'm doing... Oops. Aha! This is your chance to try again. Another Persona 4 reference, I think. Aha, is this my chance? Alright, let's teleport. Screw this walking business. Teleport there. See why I'm having so much trouble getting this key. Okay, I have to approach it from the right. So let's teleport. Hmm. Lava is present in almost every game, yet in real life you almost never encounter it. Yeah, you also almost never encounter conveyor belts and teleporters and monsters. Damn it! Alright, I think if I just head right here, I can go up and then left. Okay. I think I'm on the right track, finally. A lot of work to get this one stupid key. Okay, I can't go left yet, but if I keep going up, then I can fall down and go left from there. Yeah, there we go. I just need to keep going up here, because I died here last time or something. Oh god. Alright, yeah, I died here. Okay. Gotta be careful. Was that the right? I like where this is going. Me too, game. There we go. The Swirling Grinder, trademarked. You know that if you say TM after you say something, then it's officially trademarked and no one else is ever going to be able to use that? Like this. Duke of the Bump, TM. What is the name of Al's pet ghost that you keep forgetting to feed? Shu, Kevin, or Torgo? With Torgo, I guess. Awesome. Alright. Need to make it past the guard station. But then after I do, I only have one key left. Well, actually, is this the last key? I think it might be. Yeah. Keys left zero. Find Al. Okay. Yeah, I only had that tiny little section up there. Okay. Man, I didn't realize I was so close. Alright, let's fill in that last tiny little bit. And then I will go rescue my friend Al. And then the game will be over. Don't you actually have to pay to register it? Is that in reference to something I was talking about? The ball. Oh, TM. Yeah, I mean, in real life, not in Duke Fantasyland, yeah, you have to pay to register a trademark. Alright. Achievement unlocked. Alexander Wept. Explore the entire map. Alright. Almost there, Al. Let me just find a teleporter, and I will get over to you post-haste. When you said register it, I thought you were talking about, like, a software program or something. Alright, what is the easiest way to get to Al? Let's see, can I head up if I teleport? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, there we go. I just gotta dodge these, states of Idaho. I don't know what else to call those things. You need to have stored every key before you can face the mighty wizard. Oh, okay. So, apparently I am gonna have to fight him. It's a trap, watch out. Well, nothing else I can really do. Oh god. Where am I? This is new. This music is sinister. I am nowhere on the map. Can I actually teleport out of here? It'd be kind of funny if I could just teleport out. Alright, well, let's just head back. Welcome to my lair, LaserCat. Burn. Can you survive the final challenge, W? Oh god. Oh my god. He killed me. You are hollow. Boss fight, yes indeed. That's pretty cool. I'm glad there's actually a boss fight. Looks like it's going to be a obstacle course. An obstacle course. Of a fairly challenging nature. More challenging than anything else in the game anyway. Oh god. No checkpoints either. That sucks. It is an eggplant wizard. Oh yeah, kinda. Oh god. Oh my god. This is more challenging than I was expecting. Nice. Unjustifiable magicide. I guess it wasn't that challenging. LaserCat approached the door to Al's cell. They called for a taxi and the pair took a ride to a lovely burger bar on Titan. The end? Question mark? Total time, hour 38 minutes. Oh, not bad. Not bad for $2. I like how his name has a colon in it. Wizard colon, the magic space frog. Alright. Music by Kevin MacLeod that answers that question. Special thanks, oh, Giant Bomb. Those guys are pretty cool. Alright, well, that was LaserCat. And I still feel some streaming left in me. So just wait one moment and I will be back with some Binding of Isaac. I'm going to cut the stream to make it easier to cut the video. Alright, be back.